Jeez Orlando, get your popcorn and drink because it's about to be a long one. I told you guys that there's definitely going to be more. It's looking like this story is not going to end now, but I'm going to be bringing the gist as they come. I'm going to be dropping it as it gets hot. So we have some more information from the whole saga. In fact, things are even getting deeper. It's getting more dirty. More things are being exposed. Even down to exposing Big Brother as a whole, Big Brother Nigeria as a whole. Stay tuned, you don't want to miss this particular episode. So let me just get straight into it. Apparently, Cubana Chief Priest brought out some receipts to back up his claim. Also, Kevin's brother, that's the married guy, the brother, also brought out some counter statements to counter Cubana Chief Priest's claim. Let me begin with the one that Cubana Chief Priest posted. It's a little bit long, but I'm going to skip some things because it's not everything that is very important. So Cubana Chief Priest said, divorce was just served barely a month ago. We know they post receipts with ink cover. Slide to see dates. My sister gave up the marriage after finding out Kevin sponsored the Big Brother movement, and also when she came to Dubai to see the husband who also does not pick calls again, and lo and behold, Maria opened the door for her, putting on the husband's t-shirt. I personally gave Kelvin, who managed Maria's account while she was in Big Brother, and I also introduced them to Paulo for management. All we ask is let her not receive threats again. She has moved out of her matrimonial home in Owerri to Abuja a few days ago to get a new life. Let her be respected. They were never divorced since 2018. She just started the process, which he's yet to respond to. Gen. So all this is that he's saying, first of all, he's saying that Kevin now is the one that sponsored Maria after Big Brother. If you think, honestly, if you're going for audition and you don't have sponsor, you don't have somebody inside there, if you don't have connects, don't waste your time. This people that is mainly connects, I feel like they just bring out like 3 or 4 slots for like, okay, the general public. But some of them appeared like, okay, they were hustling major. What about me to see things and I'm like, hey, I'm not gonna say anything, but we already know, Sha, that people that is not purely a fair ground, basically, and I don't even blame themselves. So another major thing that I noted from this is the fact that he said, though, as in Cubana Chief Priest said, I personally gave Kevin, who managed Maria's account while she was in Big Brother, and also introduced them. This is even conflicting. Why she was in Big Brother to manage her account? So I don't even know, when did she even come into the picture? If he's the one that sponsored her into Big Brother, or maybe he sponsored her when she was already there, votes and everything. I don't even know what the sponsorship is all about. But basically, he said he's the one that introduced them. So, Cubana Chief Priest, why did he introduce them? Why did he introduce him to your sister's husband? Knowing fully well, based on what you're saying, you know the kind of person that this guy is, and you're introducing your sister's husband to somebody. So we have to start from there to put the blame, because that is where the genesis of this thing is coming from. He did the introduction and then also brought Paulo into the picture. The number of things that go on behind the scenes of Big Brother is just alarming and it's crazy. So he posted about like the divorce. For that one, there was a date on it, 23rd day of September 2021. All those things that he said, these are the receipts that came with it. I'm going to insert all the pages, because I feel like reading it now at this point is not going to make sense. It's a long stuff. So if you want to read everything that was said, you can pause it. Then apparently Maria has also had a conversation with the lady in question, and it was Cubana Chief Priest also brought out this particular receipt. Apparently she has had a conversation with her boyfriend's wife, and in the conversation it was kind of like an apology, apologizing to her and advising her, not just apologizing to her, also advising her. So here is the beginning of the conversation. Maria, based on what we're seeing here, Maria is the one that reached out, and this is showing Monday of May 2017. if this is the year, that means 2017 that they had this conversation, which I don't think it is. So I'm thinking that this has to be the day. Different people's WhatsApp shows different things. So for this particular one, I'm seeing Monday, May 17. You guys just make up it what you will. So she reached out to the lady. She said, "Hi, I tried calling you. I would like to sincerely..." May is before Big Brother. "I would like to sincerely apologize to you. Your number says unavailable. Kindly call me, please. And if you would rather not call, that's okay too. All I want to say is I'm truly sorry for everything." I said, "In case you listen," and that's all. As in, that's from the sister's side of this thing. She said, "In case you listen," and then Maria replied, according to this, you know, this is in case is Maria. So she now said, "Kelvin wants to work on your marriage with him. I have left all of this behind. Please kindly focus on your marriage." Hey. Oh my God. This could be coming from a good place, but to me it doesn't make sense at all. But let's keep going. As so she said, "Please kindly focus on your marriage, as this is what he wants." And the lady replied, "You achieved your goal yesterday. Ha. This is the honest truth. That's, you know, well, you guys just make up the way I'm reading it. I cannot start saying who said what, but yeah." So Maria said, You're the one who messaged me, Mary Ann. "I had absolutely no goal or intention. So apparently, I think the lady has already, you know, reached out to her before. They said, I want you to be at peace. That's why I'm messaging you." Then the lady said, "I'm no longer talking terms with my husband. I hope you're happy." And Maria said, "This is bad for you and your children." I don't know why this is funny to me. The advice is coming from the person that's supposedly your problem. For example, let's in this context, apparently Maria is the one that she's seen as a problem, just in this, and she's the one that is giving advice. Wahala here and there. "He loves you and loves those children. You should give them that at least, and leave whatever it is you feel behind. People make mistakes. Disregard whatever you might have heard from people." Then she said, "You live with him, right? Marriage will suit you both." Hey, hey, wahala. "All that is in the past," that's Maria said, "all that's in the past. Please focus on him and your marriage. Is all I've asked God to give me the strength to call and tell you." Then the lady said, "This is not my battle to fight. I leave it for you two's conscience." And Maria said, "I've never met you as a woman. I want you to be happy." The lady replied, "You are really mean. Chai. Chai, yo, chai." Then Maria said, "I have no bad conscience in this. I too have feelings and was misled. I'm feeling for you and wants you to know that he loves and wants to work on it. I'm guessing that's what she means. So apparently from this particular statement, she's saying she was misled. Misled could mean that she didn't know that the guy was married. I'm guessing that's what she means by saying that she was misled. We don't know. Maybe misled could be that he told her that he'll marry her and leave the wife, or misled could be that she didn't know that she was married at all. So, but she's saying that she was misled. So obviously the guy must have, you know, some guys have sweet mouths, you know, they have their way around things. So sometimes you might not even intend to do certain things, or you might not intend to be in a particular situation, but you just find yourself there. So this misled could mean anything. Let's keep going. The lady said, "Living with someone's husband and telling her to be at peace with him. Wow. Work is stressful." That's Maria saying, "Work is stressful. Your marriage shouldn't add to his stress." this chat is very interesting, though. Then she said, "Can you disregard this, please?" That she's telling the lady to disregard the fact that she said living with someone's husband and telling her to be at peace, that she should disregard the whole idea of her living with someone's husband. So maybe she knew, I don't know. Then she said, "No right or wrong here. Okay, can you disregard this, please? Whatever you heard of you, can you move forward and disregard all of this?" Now, you shouldn't tell someone how to, you know, act and move on, how to move on from how they feel. I think that's not right. The fact that you're even chatting with her and giving her advice, safe. Now, mind though, you get got. Someone that she's angry with, you're not coming to advise her to work on her marriage. Then the lady replied to Maria. She said, "You're the one stressing him." Maria said, "What matters is moving forward, Mary Ann. That's all I have to say." To where, please? The lady said, "To where, please?" You know, said, you're a married woman with two children, focus on your marriage with him, he wants to work on it. Then the lady now wanted her to never send her a message. She said, don't you ever send me messages in your life ever again. And Nora said, I really have one more thing to say. I'm sorry and pray God blossoms your union more. Amen. The lady said, when he's ready, you definitely won't be living with him. Then the lady said, for now, he's not. I bet you. You are a devil in disguise. I can 100% assure you he's ready. I am not living with him. Please work on your marriage. If you say so, I'll accept. Basically, it was just Maria, and this is based on what they are saying. You know, chats can be fabricated. Different things, some things could have been deleted. You get so, but this is the receipt we are seeing, and this is what we're going with for now. Until something else comes up, I'm still going to update you guys. But this is what we are seeing for now. We know that Maria and apology is 5 and 6. This particular one was definitely not approached the right way. Like, you don't reach out to somebody that you're the person that she's seen as a problem. So you coming to not tell her, yeah, work on your marriage, he wants to work on it. So my husband is not confiding in you to tell me what to do, or he's not telling you what he wants for our marriage. So it just shows that it makes it even worse. It makes matters worse to show how much closeness she has with the husband. So I don't know, it just made everything worse in my opinion, this particular conversation. That's if it happened, if everything is as it is like that. And in all of this, I'm still going to say that the man did not try at all, because it's the man that's bringing all of everything that's happening here. He's the one that's causing all of these things. If you are genuinely separated or genuinely divorced, come out, let everybody know what's going on, because all these things, we don't even know what to say. I believe maybe, you know, they're going to talk at some point, because right now we don't even know. Some say they've been separated for a long time, some say they've not been. Separation is still not divorce though. But yeah, somebody said, in Nigeria you need to be successfully separated for 2 years before you can file for divorce. So I'm guessing maybe that's why they said they've been in the process and they've not yet done the final divorce. They are trying to finalize everything and the divorce has not come into play. But according to this whole thing, it just started now, and it's the lady that's filing for divorce. So if he wanted to be out of the marriage since, why is it the lady that's filing for divorce and everything? The whole story is just a little bit mixed up, so it's hard to really even tell what's going on. Then this is the message from Kevin's brother, that's the husband's brother. My brother left his marriage since 2018, before the so-called Maria Chike Benjamin came into the picture. Man was dying in silence, but he kept his peace for the love of his children and family. Many things that happened in that marriage, but we covered it because we are a family of peace and love people, and we respected my brother's decision to try again and again for his marriage to work. But how long will a man keep trying with a woman that drags his name through every mud of shame she finds available? She drove the entire family away from her home. We don't even visit there no more. My brother was building his house while I was still in school, which I'll personally go and carry blocks to help out with the labor. Me and my younger brother will work with laborers because of the excitement that a new house is coming to our family where we could equally live and love. Peace and harmony. Live in love, peace and harmony until we grew to men of our own. Since this house was finished, I never slept a day in it because my brother's wife drove everybody away. Both my mother would visit and she would never offer her food nor drink. My brother would focus on his wife and forget his family and his mother, like he was under his spell to forget his family. And we would not complain. We left them in peace and moved on with our lives. I moved back to Enugu State where I was schooling and focused on my studies and my work until God showed me mercy. I had to bring my younger brother, whom they turned to a houseboy, to come and start living with me, and I enrolled him into the university. My brother lived in our old abandoned house in Ungwa Road in Aba, because my brother was plugging his resources in clubs of the same man who is dragging him today. This one long. the story is from all angles, I don't even understand. So basically, he now brought up more stories that are not exactly even related to this. Plenty chats have been shown, man. I cannot show everything. This matter. Then Maria has also put up a post on her page. She said, inspo for my penthouse in Lagos. It's not even related to this, obviously, although she turned off her comment section. I think maybe because a lot of people were, like, you know, obviously coming to drop in source, so she turned off her comment section on her page on Instagram, and then she went ahead to post this like 2 hours ago, or like three, by now it should be like 3 or 4 hours ago. Obviously, I feel like some people have already advised her not to say anything on this matter, just like that. And it's very good advice, because of course there's nothing she'll say at this point that people are going to listen to. Like, I even feel like it's better she just keeps, as she doesn't say anything at all, the matter will pass. She is not social media again. Before you know, 2 days, another person's issue will come up. We forget that this one is happening. She when three days ago was Siwa that was trending. Last week was Siwa that was trending. Before you know, it was Jemena that was trending. She should not just even say anything, but she should prolong the issue to something that, except maybe she has like a major receipts to back up whatever she wants to say. If not, the more maybe they keep going at it, the more it keeps prolonging, and then people will keep remembering it. But for now, silence is the best reply or answer for this kind of situation. So thanks for watching. This is where I drop my pen. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and I'm going to see you in my next video. Bye, love you.